大家有咩問題？
其實我想問翻成嗰個檢疫嘅即係政策啦嚇。頭先你都有講到就係話用家居去隔離，即係取代咗去檢疫中心咯。其實嗰條線咧嚟緊係咪即係都會係以呢個家居檢疫為主咯？個檢疫中心而家嗰個數量係咪即係個位啊非常之唔夠，所以長遠啲去考慮即係要改為家居隔離？
咁隨住呢個世界各地2019新冠狀病毒嗰個疫情發展咧，我都係睇住唔同國家地區嗰個嘅數字啦。咁呢個都係一個指標俾我哋去計劃咧，將來若果即係萬一我哋要用多啲策略去減低輸入個案嘅時候，要留意嘅方向嚟嘅。咁另外一個就係我哋要用乜嘢嘅硬件或者係規劃，去處理一啲檢疫嘅安排咧，呢個我哋需要咧深思熟慮啦。因為嗰個檢疫其實係一個特定嘅處所，我哋希望可以有一個醫學嘅即係監察啊，等佢可以睇到自己有冇發燒啊、病徵啊，然後先至有事嘅時候去醫院。呢個安排咧係俾一啲最高危嘅人士，我哋覺得適合嘅。咁譬如就係嗰啲密切接觸者啦。咁所以我哋覺得，如果當嗰個檢疫中心嘅硬件係有規劃嘅時間同埋個數量咧，係唔會係無窮無盡噶嘛，都係要分階段咧去使用或者規劃咧。咁所以根據呢個衞生嘅風險，我哋覺得喺家居做呢個檢疫咧，同樣都可以平衡進行嘅。咁所以我哋係用一個即係嗰個風險嗰個考慮咧，將一啲唔同嘅人擺唔同嘅地方。
Well, we have been looking very closely at the trend of development of the 419 COVID infection throughout the world since the outbreak happens. So, according to our observation, there's an obvious trend of increase in case and also sharp increase in cases in a number of countries, especially those in Europe. And of course, apart from Europe, we also notice there are a number of isolated imported cases from other parts of the world, for example, America, and also the tour groups from Egypt and India. And taken into all consideration, we first of all would like to include the European country first at this stage in arranging or in issuing a outbound travel alert to the Schengen states and also to Egypt because there's a group of tourists from involving Hong Kong residents coming back to Hong Kong being infected. And the second question is about
why not UK?
Okay, so we have been watching very closely the trend of development in any parts of the world also apart from the Schengen states in Europe. So we will not exclude any other additional measures toward other countries. Yes. Regarding the arrangement of quarantine, we have different locations that we can implement quarantine. One is quarantine centers and the other measure is home quarantine. As the number of quarantine facilities may be limited and also the establishment may need time, so we have to prioritize the use of quarantine facilities to cater for those with high risk, for example, close contact of confirmed cases. And for the relatively less risky cases, we think home quarantine is also an acceptable measure.
Okay.
咁其實咧，世界各地嘅疫情蔓延嗰個程度咧，我哋係知道嘅，同埋一路睇住個走勢嘅。咁我哋當然咧就係喺過去嗰兩三個禮拜都發過起碼四次唔同階段嘅紅色外遊警示，都係當當時嗰個情況咧。咁所以當然我哋唔會排除任何時候，我哋對一啲個案增加緊，同埋咧嗰個地方同香港人流係頻密嘅地方咧，再發出適當嘅旅遊警示嘅。咁另外就係關於南韓嗰、那個，喺嗰個階段咧，即係月尾嘅時候，當我哋發出對韓國一個新嘅紅色外遊警示啦，同埋咧令到一啲即係嗰陣時嘅措施就係韓國人唔可以入境，然後香港人翻到嚟就某啲檢疫安排咧，係因為嗰陣時喺內地之外嘅地方同埋國家咧，韓國係零舍一個多個嘅埋急先得好快。咁所以覺得嗰陣時，如果我哋係適當咗比較果斷嘅方法咧，令到減低兩地嘅人流啦。咁但係依家我哋睇住咧，韓國嘅疫情咧，佢當然都係主要集中喺原本嘅兩個地方，同埋有少少下跌嘅趨勢嘅。咁另外歐洲或者歐美咧，其他世界各國咧就升緊。咁所以我哋都係按住個疫情發展去部署我哋嗰、那個即係、就是、旅遊警示同埋入境之後嗰個檢疫嘅安排啦。關於唔同階段咧，我哋發出嘅旅遊警示或者係對一啲入口嘅管制啦，或者係檢疫措施都會喺度演變緊，都係睇下嗰陣時有幾多個地區被到影響，同埋個廣泛性，同埋嗰個實際可行性同埋其他考慮啦。咁所以我哋覺得喺呢個階段咧，解釋咗韓國點解我哋可以喺嗰兩個比較嚴重嘅地區。第一就唔再需要即係唔俾佢哋入境啦。另外就係喺嗰啲比較高嘅地區翻嚟咧，都係要接受呢、這個檢疫中心嘅安排啦。咁另外就係當我哋需要處理國家同埋地區多嘅時候咧，我哋預期咧可能佢哋翻嚟引致有輸入個案機會都係高嘅，所以我哋喺琴日就覺得需要增加多啲地區有紅色外遊警示，同埋當佢哋喺今日凌晨零時之後。或者十七號之後翻嚟嗰啲咧，都係分階段咧，佢哋要進行呢個家居嘅檢疫。咁頭先講到嗰個配套嘅問題啦，我哋知道咧，家居檢疫咧，首先當然佢係有一定嘅自律性啦，但係嗰個監測都係緊要嘅。咁我哋除咗透過入境嘅時候，我哋要同佢攞個方法，一係咧就係一個電子手環嘅設施啦，又或者透過呢、這個一個嘅。定位嘅一個系統就可以每日咧監察到佢有冇離開嗰個位置。咁另外，如果覺得有嘅時候咧，就有同事會俾電話嘗試揾翻佢哋問佢點解。咁另外，你都有一啲執法部門嘅人士咧，佢會去突擊去睇啲人士，咁希望可以增加嗰個力度啦。咁當然就係個刑罰本身啦。咁因為我哋見，如果佢哋喺即係講。內地翻嚟嗰個二百號法師嗰個599C呢樣嘢先啦。咁如果佢哋係即係犯咗呢個嘅規例嘅時候咧，最高刑罰可以係25,000元同埋係監禁6個月嘅。係啦，咁依家我哋喺新嘅呢一批，即係喺今日或者係17號之後實施，佢哋翻嚟之後要進行家居呢個檢疫嘅安排嘅人士咧。我哋盡量都可能 如果安排到是给他打个电子手环先。咁当然如果未有的时候可以继续用返嗰、那个即係定位嗰个措施。
教授。
係。嗱咁我哋其实喺嗰个嘅加强监测呢喺一月中都陆续推展嘅。咁当然呢如果首先係嗰啲已经呈报咗个案合嗰个卫生署规定呈报个案呢就一定入院做检查啦。咁但係除此以外，我哋其實一月中開始已經，就算嗰位人士佢唔係達到嗰個情報嘅要求咧，佢如果入咗醫院係有肺炎嘅跡象，或者任何嘅肺炎，或者個醫生有懷疑嘅時候，都會將我做檢測。然後最近亦都將呢一個嘅即係實驗室嘅監察嘅系統推到去好多方面診同埋急症室啦，亦都繼而咧去到私家診所。咁私家診所咧，其實有時佢哋接觸嗰啲個案，可能係非常之輕微嘅象徵嘅，可能係即係少少鼻水啊、幾聲咳啊、少少喉嚨痛咧，有少少身興啊咁樣咧。其實我哋都係覺得私家醫生可以幫呢啲病人咧做一個即係嗰個化驗室嘅檢測。咁呢個咧都大大咗幫到我哋可以做啲化驗喺社區嘅個案啦。咁喺呢個冇病徵嘅人士嗰度咧，其實都有一啲局部嘅群組，我哋有做到嘅，即係譬如話喺即係鑽石公眾號翻嚟初進入呢個檢疫中心嗰班人士啦，或者係一啲支援北返港嘅人士啦，都有一啲測試，我哋喺嗰度咧去嘗試揾一啲個案出嚟嘅。咁如果喺唔同地方翻嚟嗰啲人咧，我相信即係如果香港人大部分都有一個居所喺度啦。咁但如果係一啲外國人，咁有時佢可能根本係喺度做事嘅，咁亦都可以有一個地址啦。咁但萬一如果佢喺香港唔可以提供一個地址嘅話咧，依家衞生防護中心嘅建議都係首選要將我哋安排喺嗰個檢疫中心度進行檢疫。
咁但係萬一即係如果佢哋去走，咁佢哋即係選擇喺酒店隔離，係咪即係都會容許佢哋都？
暫時唔會考慮呢樣嘢，暫時覺得如果佢唔能夠提供個家居地址進行家居檢疫咧，就覺得應該比較好嘅安排去檢疫中心。
翻轉機方面咧，點都可以 make sure 到啲旅客咧，譬如法國咁樣，而家目前淨係禁止咗兩個地區嘅人需要翻嚟，如果去過兩個地區嘅人就要翻嚟做家居檢疫啦。咁但係如果佢係，譬如佢係轉機去即係巴黎島翻嚟嘅話，或者其他地區翻嚟。
依家其實嗰個新嘅措施咧，就喺17號之後咧，喺神根公約底下嘅國家翻嚟嘅人士咧，都係要進行呢個家居檢疫嘅。咁已經包括咗，譬如法國啊、德國啊。
轉飛東南亞再入嚟香港，
咁點樣確保佢哋？咁喺入境嘅時候，當然會，譬如話衞嗰個國家衞生嘅同事，或者係入境處嘅同事會睇翻佢啲旅遊記錄噶嘛。如果14日之內佢去過呢個神根公約嘅國家咧，都係要接受嗰個安排啦。
多謝各位，唔該曬，拜拜。